Human umbilical cord mesenchymal stem cells. So, first of all, as the name suggests, those are stem cells that are obtained from the umbilical cord right after giving birth. This means that there are no ethical concerns whatsoever for using this tissue and for using this these cells. The cells are very easily harvested from the umbilical cord. And this can be from just the blood inside the umbilical cord up to the whole tissue or subparts from the umbilical cord, such as the Wharton jelly tissue, which surrounds the blood vessels in the umbilical cord. There are two ways of harvesting these stem cells. The first one is the explant outgrowth. As you can see here, this is just that you put small pieces of umbilical cord inside a culture disc. You wait for several days or several weeks, excuse me, and after this you will have cells migrated out of the tissue into the dish. This takes very long, it takes a couple of weeks, but you do have a high number of cells, so a high yield. You have higher proliferation rates and it's very inexpensive. The second method that you have for harvesting mesenchymal stem cells from the umbilical cord is the enzymatic digestion method. This one is relatively fast, it only takes a few hours, but because you cut up the umbilical cord and you add certain enzymes such as collagenase that cleave the cells and make it into a homogeneous suspension. But this gives you a lower number of cells and also a lower yield. And there's a higher risk of contamination because of all the steps and the handling that needs to be done. So what are the benefits of using umbilical cord mesenchymal stem cells? There are no ethical concerns whatsoever when harvesting these cells because the umbilical cords are medical waste. Mesenchymal stem cells can also be obtained from bone marrow or from fat, but you can imagine that those are still medical procedures. But the umbilical cord harvesting is non-invasive. While if you want mesenchymal stem cells from bone marrow or fat, it's a medical procedure that you are into. Also, those cells have a higher expansion potential compared to the bone marrow or the fat-derived mesenchymal stem cells. And this is simply because these cells are only 9 months old. Fourthly, those cells have immunosuppressive properties, which means that those cells secrete certain factors that have a positive reaction on the immune system, which means that the immune system will not try to destroy these cells upon transplantation. So there's less risk of rejection after transplantation. Also, there is no teratoma formation because those stem cells are not pluripotent anymore. And if you remember the pyramid we have been talking about before, if you go to the pluripotent level of stemness, we find the embryonic stem cells and the induced pluripotent stem cells. Which means that those cells can still differentiate into every other cell that's inside the body. And you can imagine that if you transplant one of these cells in a certain or just a random part of the body, they will start differentiating into all several types of cells because they get all these different cues. And that's how a teratoma gets formed. And a teratoma is simply put just a tumor that consists of several cell types and tissue types.